so here's a little tidbit about Black history, and this is not so far in the past history. This is more so like recent history. The person I want to highlight today is Octavia E. Butler. Octavia is a, or was a science fiction writer. She died February 24th of 2006. She died at the age of 58. She's a multiple recipient of both the Hugo and the Nebula Awards. She was one of the best known women in the field. In 1995, she became the first science fiction writer to receive the MacArthur Fellowship, nicknamed the Genius Grant. A friend of mine has a page dedicated to her on Facebook and did her thesis on Octavia Butler, which is how I know her. The books that you might know or may not know are her most popular books were the Patternist series, Kindred, which she published in 1979, Lilith's Blood, and the Parable series. So if you're a person who likes to read and you're maybe into science fiction, Octavia E. Butler, I recommend you read her books. I know several people who've read them and love them. I haven't gotten to them yet, but I will get to them. Okay, so that's your African-American, Black African-American history tidbit for this video. So in honor of Black History Month, I am gonna do the Black Girl Tag.
Black Girl Tag
questions. I've taken a couple of questions from the Black Girl Tag that Aviel did a year ago that she made up, and then from the other one that's been floating around. So the first question is, black gel or jam? The truth is, when I did put jam in my hair or gel in my hair, I used both. I stopped using gel and such right when black gel first came out. I think they both smell terrible. Even though, like, after a while I got used to the black gel because it was kind of like, oh, it means my hair is done. It's like, oh, this smell that I don't like means that my hair is laid or whatever. but yeah, I don't use them anymore. It's been over 10 years since I've used them. And that's that. I will have a quick story though about black gel. I was on set for this zombie movie and they were using black gel to put in the people, like the zombie people's hair. So it was mainly white people. So it came out as like black gook, almost looking like dried blood. And some makeup artist was like, oh, look at this ugly, gross gel. Like, I guess I just got it for this show because it dries gross. And I was so close to putting him in his place and being like, actually, this gel that black people use for their hair, and going off on him. But I was just like, you know what? Now is not the time, Muhammad. Now is not the time. It was like 12 midnight and I was tired and I would have went off on him and I like pulled myself back. Number two, does your name have Isha in it? No. But I will say that my favorite Muslim turned ghetto name is Aisha. Aisha, you are the girl that I never had, and I want to get to know you better. It's so sweet. Do you roll your neck or your eyes? Yes. How often do you get an attitude? What does that mean? What does that mean when you get an attitude? How often do you get annoyed by people and show it? Because everyone gets an attitude. It's not a black girl thing. Like, you get an attitude when you get annoyed. So I don't know what that means, but yes. How often? Whenever somebody annoys me, because I'm a person, I'm allowed to have my feelings. Do you like Taylor Swift? Do I like Taylor Swift? No. Do I know that Shake It Off song? Yes. Do I like the blank, sign your name, blank space. I like that song. Have you ever dated a white guy? Yeah, girl. Do you wear a weave? And if so, how often? Never in my life. Are you light skin or dark skin? Why did I even ask that question? Skip. Are you loud or quiet? I'm loud, but that has nothing to do with me being black. Do you prefer braids or rope twists? I don't know what rope twists are, so I prefer braids. Just For Me or Shea Moisture? I thought Just For Me was a kid's brand, and I thought Shea Moisture was an adult and a kid's brand. But Shea Moisture, because I don't do relaxers. Are you ratchet? I can't be ratchet. I'm not from the part of the world where people are ratchet. Has your weave ever fallen out? No. Do you pat your head or do the assisted scratch? Yes. Who is your favorite black couple? Angela Bassett and Courtney Vance. What black women do you look up to? Oprah, Whoopi, Angela, Jill. I already talked about these ladies. I was about to say.
I talk about these bitches. I love them.
What's your favorite thing about being a black woman? assumed status and assumed style. I like the fact that people automatically assume that I have style. And I like the fact that people automatically assume that I'm like, ethereal. It's not that I'm strong, it's just that like, I know who I am. Like, I mean, there's pros and cons with that, but I do like the assumption that I'm like strong and that people automatically aren't gonna test me because of it. I rarely ever get tested. My friend Rebecca, who's white, she gets tested all the time. Sometimes people, she tells me the stories of people doing stuff to her and she's like, what was I supposed to do? And I'm like, girl, I have no idea what you were supposed to do because people do not treat me like that. And I don't know if it has anything to do with me being specifically being a black woman or just the way I carry myself, but I don't get treated the way that some of my white friends get treated. And I'm kind of grateful for that. I'm kind of grateful that people just won't try me because they think I'm gonna go off. And I probably will, but not in the way they think. What is your name? My name is Wahima Lino. Show the scarf or bonnet you sleep in. Girl, you have seen, I don't know where, it's upstairs. You've seen it. Look at my other video. I'm gonna link a video. I'm gonna link all my morning teas down below and you'll see what bonnet or scarf I sleep in. What is your favorite black movie? The Color Purple and Coming to America, and then Friday coming in third. What is your most memorable try me moment? I haven't had a memorable try me moment. None that I can think of, and if I can think of it later on, I'll say it in a video another time, but people don't really try me. I feel like the only people who do try me are my family members, and you know, that, I'm not gonna talk about that. How do you tame your edges? Girl, I don't tame my edges, okay? My hair does not need to be tamed. It is strong and dominant, and it is living its natural life. What's your favorite dance? The WAP is my favorite dance. I really enjoy doing the troop. I also enjoy the Dougie. What's your favorite soul food? I don't really be messing with soul food like that. I'm beyond that collard greens and ham hocks and black eyed peas tip, but I did have some bomb ass black eyed peas this Christmas. First time I ever had black eyed peas where I was like, girl. But to me, beans pretty much all taste the same because my dad seasons them the exact same way. But my aunt made the black eyed peas this time and they were good. They were good. They were great. I think anytime you put like a smoked turkey leg in a pot of beans, it's gonna be good. I love me some sweet potato pie, macaroni and cheese, but is macaroni and cheese really soul food? Like, I don't know that it's soul food anymore. It's southern food, definitely, but soul food, I'm not sure. But I can do some macaroni and cheese. It has to be good. And not all macaroni and cheese is good. I think sweet potato pie is gonna really have to take it as my, like, favorite soul food situation. Have you seen the following? Love and Basketball, Friday, The Color Purple, or Boys in the Hood? Love and Basketball, yes. The first time I saw it, I was floored and it took me out of my mind. The second time I saw it, I was like, oh, this is not as good as I thought it was. So it doesn't hold up or stand the test of time for me. The Color Purple holds up, stand the test of time. Friday holds up, stand the test of time. Boys in the Hood, I've seen it probably 3 times. I still don't remember it. Like, I just remember the dude running through the alley and then somebody getting shot. Like, I remember one of them was supposed to, Morris Chestnut was supposed to be the kid that was gonna go to college. I just can't, I feel like I get it and Menace to Society mixed up. And I know they're different movies and I know one has Lorenz Tate in it. Remember him, Lorenz Tate? But I don't know, I can't distinguish the two movies and that's my bad. Can you dance? Do you have rhythm? Yes and yes. What slang do you use? I often say, girl. I say that a lot. Call men girl too. Like, I'm like, no girl. He's like, well, I'm not a girl. I call everybody girl. Get over it. I use the N-I-G-G-A word. I do. Are you natural or relaxed? Girl. Natural. Do you own a pair of Tims, Jordans, or Nikes? No, no, yes. Nikes, I own them for like running and working out. But Tims, no girl. I lived in New York City for 6 years and I was like, oh, I'm gonna give me some Tims. That's not my stilo, you know what I'm saying? I don't roll with Tims or Jordans. I'm not a sneaker girl. And if I do wear sneakers, it's gonna be like the sneaker wedges. Finish the song. I get so weak in the knees, I can hardly breathe. I lose all control when something takes over me. In a day, you look so amazing. It's not a face. I want you to stay with me by my side. I swallow my pride. Your love is so sweet. It knocks me right off of my feet. Can't explain why your love it makes me weak. I hope those words are right. Who is your black woman crush? Amara. Who do I think is really beautiful? I try hard to fight it. No way can I deny it. Your love so sweet knocks me off my feet. I get so weak. Boy, it's something I can't explain. I get so weak. Something about the way you do the things you do. Ooh, ooh. Knocks me right off of my la 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 la. Can't explain why your love makes me weak. Who's my crush? Gabrielle Union is the only name that's popping into my head, but she's not my crush. I don't know, girl. I'll have to get back to you on that one too. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. I hope you have a fantastic day and a great weekend, and I'll talk to you later. Bye!